In this video, we'll try to understand how we can create dynamic cascading dropdowns in SQL Server reporting service. Now, what do I mean by dynamic cascading dropdowns? In the previous example, if you remember, we had created a dropdown. Now, this dropdown was good, you know, but the problem with this dropdown was that the values are hard-coded inside the parameters, right? So, if you remember, inside the parameters, we had actually hard-coded the values. But what if tomorrow, if somebody goes and adds a new country over here, those values will not be reflected here directly, right? You have to again go and do an add, deploy the report, etc., etc. So how about going and pulling these values, you know, from this table over here, right? So that would be a proper solution. So for that, what we need to do is we need to go and get the values from a query, right? So the first step what we need to do here is we need to go and create a data set. So let me go and create a data set which actually goes and fetches all the country values, right? So let me go and add a data set over here. So we'll say here, use the existing data source. So if you remember, right, in our data sources, we had already created a data source called as data source one. So what we'll do is we're going to go and reuse this data source one rather than creating a new one again and again. Okay. So add data set, reuse this existing data source one, and let's go and click on this query designer and let's add the table that is country master. Now we need two things over here. One is the country ID. And the other one is the country name, right? So I'm going to use both of them, country ID and country name. Okay. And okay. So we have created, you know, a data set here called as data set two, which has country ID and a name column, right? Now we need to go and attach this data set two with our parameters. So let's go and edit again the parameter properties. Let's go to available values. Now we'll say that do not use the specify values, but get the values from a query. Okay. And what is that query? That query is data set two, which we just created. And we'll say the value of the field is country ID and the label of the field is country name. Say, okay. And that's it. So now what will happen is, you know, every time this parameter gets filled, he will actually fetch the value from country ID and country name. So if I do a preview now very quickly, so there the value is filled and this value is fetched from the database. So if you see in the database, we have IND, USA, NEP, Sri Lanka. So the same value is over here, right? Great. So rather than hard coding, now the values are coming from the database and that is really good. Okay. So this is called as dynamic parameters. Okay. In other words, the value is coming from the database, you know, rather than hard coding. Now, if you wish, you can do some more couple of improvements over here. For example, now this is a multi-select. Okay, but logically it should just be a single select, right? So what you can do is you can go and edit your parameters and you can say do not allow multiple values. So if you do this, you know, your dropdown becomes a single select. Now you can see this is a single select value, right? So if I select India and let me do a view report. Oh, I don't see any data. Why? Let's go ahead. And let's edit data set one. See, remember, we have two data sets here. One is data set two, which actually fills this drop down, right? The country drop down. And then we have data set one, which actually fills our report, right? So let's go ahead and see what's there in the query. Now, if you see in this query here, we are using the country name parameter and we are searching by the text country name. But actually, if you remember, right, our data set two, or rather I'll say the parameter is binded with the value country ID that is numeric. So what we need to do is we need to actually go and change this to customer.countryID, because now we are no more using the hard-coded value, and in the dynamic value we are using the number as the value. Number means this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So what I've done is I've gone ahead and I've changed that country master.country name to customer.countryid_fk so that he makes a numeric search rather than searching on the country name, right? The text. Right. Now I should be able to see the values. So if I select India, there it is. Great. If I select USA, there it is. Nepal. There it is. Nice. So this is good. Now we are able to load this drop down dynamically from the table, and also we are able to see the report. Now let me go and add some more complications, you know, to this report here. Now let us say we want to add one more drop down input parameter to this report called as the city drop down. And the city drop down is populated, you know, depending on what country is selected in the country drop down. So what we are saying here is that basically when somebody goes and selects US here, right, then accordingly the cities of US should be populated in that drop down. So how do we go about doing this? So first thing, let me just explain you my database design over here. So you can see that we have this city master table over here, and the city master table has city ID, city name and country ID, and this country ID links this city master with the country master. So you can see over here the country ID is 1 and 1 is linked to India. So this country ID is the linkage, it's a foreign key to the country master, right? So the first thing what we need to do now is let's go ahead and let's edit our report in our design mode. Let's go to report data, and first thing, let's go ahead and add a data set which will actually go and fetch, you know, this city master. That's the first thing we need to do, and we'll say here use the data source 1 which we already have, and in the query designer we'll go and select the city master, and we will need city name as well as city ID. And here what we'll do is we'll say here that the value that this data set records, you know, will depend on the country name parameter, right? So we have this country name parameter, on that, you know, this value should be fetched, right? So in other words, what we have done now is, you know, this data set 3 is attached with this country name value. So whatever this country name value will, whatever, you know, value we'll have in this country name parameter will be applied to this data set 3, right? Right, now let's go ahead and add a parameter here. This is nothing but our city, right? And we'll say get the values from data set 3, which actually fetches our cities, city ID, city name. Say okay. Now let me do a preview. So there we are. So you can see now, because no country name is selected, the city is disabled. But if I go and select IND India, it actually displays me the city of India. So if you remember, in our table, India had two cities, one is Mumbai and the other one is Delhi. And yes, it is Mumbai and Delhi. If I go and select Nepal, it will display me Kathmandu and Pokhara, right? So you can see now, you know, depending on this parameter over here, this drop down value, the other drop down value is getting fetched, right? So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand how we can create dynamic drop down and cascading drop downs using SQL Server reporting services. Thank you so much.